In this video, I'll demonstrate several cost-saving techniques using Aider, including Aider's cost-effective settings, from caching, refactoring large files, using Claude 3.5 Haiku, which is the latest release of Claude, and a human-as-model approach. We'll apply these techniques while improving an existing project called AI Prompt Architect, or APARC for short. It's an app that helps generate the prompts you need to create an app using tools like Bolt. I have loaded the repository in my desktop VS Code here. I have already set up Aider and added the necessary API key for Claude. If you need help with this step, there's a separate video link in the description. Our first cost-saving tip is to use Aider's documentation website instead of its interactive help chat, which can incur costs. Aider already tries to save costs by default. It uses a concise map of your entire Git repository. To save even more, we can turn on Claude's prompt caching. To enable prompt caching in Aider, we can run it with --cache prompts. Another way to save is by using Claude 3.5 Haiku. This is the latest and fastest model from Anthropic. It's more affordable than their best model, Claude 3.5 Sonnet. Now let's go back to Visual Studio Code. If we run Aider, we can see its default settings. I'm running the latest version of Aider, version 0.62. And since I have provided an Anthropic API key, the main model is set to Claude 3.5 Sonnet. So first, let's set Haiku, the latest version, as the main model. Let me quit Aider by using /quit. To enable prompt caching and to use Haiku, we can run Aider with the flag --haiku and --cache prompts. And comparing the settings, you can see that the prompt cache here is already enabled. Using Haiku, we can maintain performance while reducing costs. So we will use Claude 3.5 in different ways throughout this video, so stay tuned. If we take a look at our code, specifically the story-driven prompts, we can see that the file is over 400 lines long, 425 to be exact, which can confuse the AI model and increase costs. In my experience, the ideal threshold is 300 lines. With a target of around 200 lines, 250 at most. But you might wonder, why do I have such a large file? Well, Bolt created it for me earlier when I was developing APARC hands-off without touching any code. This illustrates what happens when we solely rely on AI to write code without human intervention to refine and optimize it. But we can still optimize this by refactoring the large file into smaller components. We will be able to minimize token usage and make it easier for the AI to process. However, if we ask the AI to break this component down into multiple components in one go, we'll likely confuse it, leading to incorrect or unexpected results. Let me demonstrate what I mean. Let's ask Aider to break this down into smaller components. And this is another tip that I'd like to share. Aider can read all the files by using the repo map, but it doesn't have the file contents by default. So in order to process the contents of the file, we need to add it to the chat history or to the chat context. We can add all of the files here inside the chat context, but that will unnecessarily increase the token usage and will make AI development much problematic. So what we need to do is use Aider's /add command, which will specifically add a specific file to the chat like so. So if we take a look at all the files by using /ls, Aider knows that these are the repo files, but they are not in the chat. And if we scroll down a bit, we can see the files in the chat, which is the one we just added explicitly. So now the entire content of this file is in the chat, ready to be sent to Claude. Now, let's try to refactor this in one go, as I said. Let's say refactor. I anticipate this to fail, so let's just wait for a bit. Here, we can see that Aider is struggling, particularly the AI model, not necessarily Aider. Aider automatically committed the changes it made, and if we take a look at the source control, it didn't actually create a new file, but it did some change here. And we can see that Aider attempted to create several files, but it didn't do that for some reason. So we will circle back to this later. But the point is, if we have a large file like this, it's difficult for the AI model to process, even the best ones. I have tried several Aider setups to overcome this issue without success before this video. video. So now we're facing a paradox. Since we cannot break this down into multiple components and we can't fix the issues as is, we need to break this down gradually using a divide and conquer approach. I will undo this change. We can also use /undo here if you want. Let's make sure that the file has been reverted back to its original state. And then let's try another approach. Let's start by asking the AI to split the file in a more logical way. So if we open this file, let's analyze it for a bit. We can see at the top here that there are several interfaces and variables that we can move out of this file, and we can save 100 lines of code there. I can move it manually, but let's ask Aider to do it for us. So let me reset the chat history to start over, and then let me add back story-driven prompts again, and then this time we will ask Aider a different prompt. Let's try this prompt. I still anticipate this to fail, but that's the reality of working with AI tools. Instead of presenting a polished, unrealistic video, I'll show you the genuine challenges we face and how to overcome them. And rather than complaining, let's rise to the occasion and tackle these issues head on. And look, Aider completed the changes. Let's say yes. We can take a look at the commits here. Let's install Prettier. As you can see, there's no file matching the pattern found. So Aider is having trouble here. Let's take a look at the commit. Yes, there's no new files created by Aider. Aider's latest version occasionally struggles to create new files. Fortunately, Aider meticulously documents its actions in the history file, and we can review it here. We can review this file to understand Aider's intentions, and then ironically aid Aider in accomplishing its task. So rather than whining, let's do our best to tackle this issue and find the solution. So let me just clear the changes here because it didn't succeed. And let's try the undo command to undo this commit made by Aider. Alright, so let's see the Aider's history file again. So this is our prompt. Extract the types and so on, and this is Aider's response. So it's trying to create a new file called story-driven-types.ts. So it's located here. So let's help Aider. Let's create that new file, and then let's see. Let's reopen the chat history and double click it so that it won't disappear when I open a new file. So this is the content. So we can copy all of this and then paste it into this new file and save. Let's go back and see what else is needed to be done. Now it's trying to update the story-driven prompts. It's searching for the code to be replaced. And then this is the replacement code. Let's copy it and manually paste in all those codes here. So we will replace all of this until here. Alright, let's save. And we have an error here. Paste is defined but never used, so we can remove it manually. Now let's go back to the chat history and see if there are any more changes to do. Okay, so I think we're done. So these changes will create the story-driven types. We already created that. And update the imports here. We already did that. And it preserved all existing logic and structure. So it did what it's supposed to do, but it failed to create the new file. And since Aider is tracking all the changes via this file, we were able to help Aider to do those changes. And if we take a look at Aider release log. Here, Aider now supports applying of file edits from ChatGPT, Claude, or other web apps. That means the chat with ChatGPT or Claude via their web app can be applied by Aider to our Git repository. We need to use the web app's copy response button to copy the entire reply from the LLM and then run this command in our Visual Studio Code. And Aider will edit your file with the LLM's changes. So why bother? This allows us to use code suggestions from ChatGPT or Claude AI without incurring additional API costs. Because we only pay the fixed monthly subscription, we're already paying for pro accounts. So this is really a nice feature. Let's see how we can use this. Let's go back to Visual Studio Code. This time I will refactor another file. Let's close all of this. And I will try to refactor another story-related component here. This user story section. It's also quite large, 284 lines of code. I'm hesitant fun to use this as an example because this is almost 300 lines of code. But let's see, I will use Claude AI to ask for the refactoring of this component. Let me go to Claude AI and let's paste in our code and let's ask Claude to refactor this file. It extracted the types separately, the utility function separately, and finally updating the main component. So let's wait for a bit. So now let's use the generated code and apply it using Aider. So let's copy the chat response. Then let's go back to Visual Studio and run Aider using this plug. Let's press yes. Okay, let's see what Aider did. Looks like Aider is still having trouble creating new files, but we can see its intention here. And we can see the contents of each file if we scroll down a bit here. We can help Aider again. If we check our npm run dev, we're still good and there are no errors. So the refactoring works. By the way, the component we're trying to change is this. And it's still working. Now let's commit our changes. Another cost-saving strategy is to use libraries with concise syntax, such as Svelte. That's why I consistently use Svelte in my other videos. I plan to convert APARC to Svelte in the future. To recap, we've explored several cost-saving techniques using Aider, leveraging its cost-effective settings from caching, selectively adding relevant files, refactoring large files, utilizing Claude 3.5 Haiku, and implementing the human as model approach, where we copy the changes from Claude AI web interface and ask Aider to apply those changes. While we encountered some challenges, it's important to note that this isn't always the case. I have demonstrated that when issues arise, we can actively address them. That's the beauty of using a flexible tool like Aider. It allows us to adapt and overcome obstacles. In future videos, I'll delve deeper into the development of AI prompt architect, showcasing advanced features and providing more insights. I'll also share the finished product with everyone. So if you found value in this video, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and tap the notification bell to stay updated on future content. Thanks for watching and happy coding!